Figure 6.2 shows two rays from a point object Q incident on another water surface. So this is your point object Q. An observer sees the image of Q produced by refraction at the surface of the water. The water surface is here. So the observer's eye will come somewhere over here. So he is observing from this side. On figure 6.2, draw possible refracted rays and complete the diagram to locate a possible position of the image. Label the position of the image J. You do not need to calculate any angles. Okay, so this is the diagram that we are having on which we are supposed to construct the refracted rays. And we are supposed to obtain the position of the image. Okay, so now this are the incident rays. This is the first incident ray. So through that point, first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a normal. At the same time, I'm also going to draw the normal for the other ray. Okay, now because this ray is going to travel from water to air, that is denser medium to rarer medium, therefore it is going to bend away from the normal. Okay, so these rays are going to bend away from the normal. So this is the ray that I'm going to take up. The first ray that is there, that's I'm going to draw from here. Is going to bend away from the normal. The second ray that is there, that is also going to bend away from the normal. See that the bending is greater because for the first ray there is certain angle of incidence. For the second ray the angle of incidence is greater. So for this the angle of refraction also has to be greater. And now these rays I'm going to produce in the backward direction. And I'm going to obtain the position of the image. Okay, this is approximately that those rays which are being produced in the backward direction. Same way here, this ray is also produced in the backward direction. And this is how, where these both rays, the purple colored lines are going to intersect, that is going to be the position of the image. Okay, so this is your position of the image. This image has to be labeled J. Of course, these purple lines which are there, you are going to show them dotted. The rays which are going to travel, you will mark the arrows for that. So this will be the direction of the refracted rays. These refracted rays when produced backwards. Okay, approximately you should remember that this point J, okay, should be quite in line with this point Q when you are drawing this vertical line. Okay, you can just complete the diagram. If you have any questions, you can ask me.
Some amount of light will get reflected, that is true what you are telling, but total internal reflection is going to take place only if this angle of incidence is more than critical angle. In that case only total internal reflection is going to take place. No refraction will take place. All the light that is there will undergo total internal reflection. Some amount of light does get reflected, that is true, but major part of the light ray is going to get refracted, and this is the position of the image that is obtained when refraction is taking place.